surrounded on every side. You better get out of there.
I think he deserved what he got.
What do you mean?
He hit a woman. Steamboat hit a woman. That is the bottom line.
Fans will be talking to Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. Take another look at that situation right here this week on WCW Worldwide. Fans, we also have all the top superstars. JT Southern is with us. We saw him last week. This man says he can play the guitar better than anyone and wrestle better than anyone.
Well, that remains to be seen. I'll be the judge of that.
Jesse the Body Ventura will be with us as well. All the top superstars, and everybody's talking about Sting and Big Van Vader for the world title.
That's right. You know, Sting won the title, but he's facing the most vicious competitor, I think, ever in Van Vader. He's also giving up well over 200 pounds of body weight.
It certainly could make a difference. And Jesse and I will be back with our first match on Worldwide from Topeka right after this timeout.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest, tag team action, it is set for one fall. Introducing team number one. First from the Diamond Mine, weighing 249 pounds, Diamond Dallas Hayes.
That's right, baby. Check it out.
From the mine,
Benny Vegas and Diamond Dallas Page making their way to the ring here on WCW Worldwide. Jess, Benny Vegas is a big guy, around 6'10".
He's a big guy, but he dresses like every Vinny I know, horribly.
And ladies and gentlemen, there are the opponents. Introducing first, from Sweetwater, Texas, 278 pounds, Barry Windham. And from Austin, Texas, 261 pounds, the natural Dustin Rhodes.
What a tremendous ovation for Barry Windham and the natural Dustin Rhodes. Two men who, as we know very well, are hot after Larry Zbyszko and Stunning Steve Austin. And these two men, being tall Texans, feel they can settle the score, Jess, in the ring in either a bunkhouse match or a double bull rope match.
Well, that's true, Tony, but if you ever noticed a Texican that don't brag, I mean, every Texican I know in the world is a big bragger.
And many of them can fight, and these two men can really do it.
Oh, they can do that, but they also brag a lot.
Collar and elbow tie-up now. Dustin Rhodes sends Diamond Dallas Page back in. Here's a very arrogant guy, Diamond Dallas Page. And a shove, and Dustin's not going to take any part of it at all.
Uh-oh.
Rhodes him up. A two count.
Much too early to get a rolling cradle like that. Diamond Dallas Page too big and too strong to be held down for a three count.
Held onto the hair. Our Dustin would have had him into the near side rope.
Absolutely, but he hit it very well from the referee. Referee could not break it. Did it again. I love it.
Good arm drag takedown by Dustin. There's the big flip, flop, and fly. The elbow right on target, right at the top of the head. And here comes Barry Windham. Right on the chest one more time. You know, Barry and Dustin, quite a duo, but they want to settle a score. They're not looking after a title.
I'll tell you, Windham, for a guy his size, has to be one of the most agile wrestlers to ever step in that ring.
Right hand by Page. Page came out swinging, but Barry rolls him up, hooks a leg, and almost got a three count out of it. Back to the point of attack once again.
They're exchanging right hands out there.
They really are.
Windham got caught now. He got caught in the wrong corner. Here comes Big Vinny Vegas.
Block both of them. And Vinny Vegas doing some blocking of his own, but Windham, like you said, being very agile and very quick, got the better of him. Now back to the corner.
What would you call those, passionate pink pants?
I would think that would be the right term for it. No one dresses like Vinny Vegas.
Well, at least they're not canary yellow.
That is a two count. And a right hand. Yeah, I would agree. I don't like that color either, man. Pick up, belly to back suplex, and a great move by Vinny Vegas.
Well, I'll tell you, the big man shows us a little bit of wrestling right there. He's strutting his stuff. What is he, about 6'10", isn't he?
6'10", well over 300 pounds. He's rolled up by Windham. But Windham only got a one count out of it. Right hand to the head. Now, Windham.
Well, I got a question something here, Tony Schiavone. Why are they allowing Windham to have that fist taped up like that? Well, it's obvious it's not hurt because he's throwing right hands with it.
Well, I think he still has an injury, and under doctor's orders, he has it taped up, an injury caused by Larry Zbyszko.
He might have used to have an injury. He don't got it no more.
Tell you what, in a bunkhouse match, they can tape up both fists, Jesse. They can use boots.
That's true, but we're not looking at no bunkhouse match here tonight.
A knee to the midsection, and Diamond Dallas Page getting the better of Dustin right now. Back to a neutral corner. DDP will scoot him to the other side. Dustin ducked out of the way. Larry kick move. Two, and Vinny Vegas came in for the save. And now Barry Windham comes in to cut off Vinny.
And knocks Vinny out to the floor, and Windham's following him out there. Oh, catches a right hand.
Dustin ducked two times. Bulldog! The quickness of Dustin Rhodes gets a knee kick.
Thanks, Tony. I'm Eric Bischoff, and this is the WCW Magazine for the week ending April 12th, 1992. The new edition of WCW Magazine hits newsstands nationwide this week. On the front and back cover, you'll find the team signed to compete in War Games. War Games is a part of the WrestleWar 92 pay-per-view exclusive, and it presents the participants with a situation so dangerous that it's only going to happen once this year. Two rings surrounded by a steel cage covered with steel. Only one way in, and survival the only way out. Will War Games be the nail in the coffin of the Dangerous Alliance? Well, Dangerous Lee's team of ravishing Rick Rude, stunning Steve Austin, Arn Anderson, Larry the Cruncher Zbyszko, and Bobby Eaton? They don't think so. But according to Sting, the Sting Squadron will dismantle the Dangerous Alliance, and Sting is a powerful and experienced team preparing for War Games. Dustin Rhodes, Barry Windham, and Ricky the Dragon Steamboat, there's no doubt that they're the foundation of the team. But the wild card, it's Nikita Koloff. Now, there's no question that Koloff brings experience and power to the team. But he also brings a question that so far remains unanswered. It's a question of loyalty. And later on in the hour, we'll be hearing from Koloff, and we'll get his thoughts on the upcoming War Games. And we'll hear from Arn Anderson and Paul E. Dangerously about this pay-per-view exclusive coming your way May 17th. Right now, let's get back down to the ring to Tony Schiavone and Jesse the Body Ventura.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest, it is set for one fall. Introducing first, from Macon, Georgia, weighing 234 pounds, he says he's the greatest in World Championship Wrestling, Johnny B. Bag. His opponent from Panama City, Florida, 213 pounds.
Well, Jesse, I'm going to be honest with you. I've been waiting 4 long weeks to see what you would have to say about Johnny B. Badd.
Well, I guess all you can say, Tony Schiavone, is everybody's entitled to their own heroes, right?
Yeah.
And, you know, this guy obviously is hero's Little Richard.
I would think so.
Now, why anybody on the face of the earth would have Little Richard as their hero is beyond me.
Johnny B. Badd is... it's like a one-man parade in many ways. One of the top contenders to Flying Brian in the WCW Light Heavyweight title. Listen to the fans. They love it.
All I can say, Schiavone, I guess it's the 90s when boys do wear eye mascara.
Johnny B. Badd set to go in this event here on WCW Worldwide. And his opponent, Jesse Curls. Now there's another Jesse down in the ring. My God.
Oh, wait a minute, Schiavone. Don't equate just because he's got my name that he wrestles like I did.
Well, I'm not saying he wrestled like you did, Jesse. Certainly, he doesn't have the same head of hair that you have, but
the only thing close in that ring was Johnny B. Badd's feathered boa. I was partial to a boa occasionally. Boom! That's a closed fist.
And you're saying the referee should not count right
there? The referee should not count right there. That's an illegal move.
Ladies and gentlemen, here's your winner, Johnny B. Badd.
We'll be back.
Okay, Jess, as you know, the man hot on the trail, the World Heavyweight Champion, is the awesome 450-pound Big Van Vader. Let's hear these comments from the World Champion Sting at this time.
Well, Big Van Vader, if you weigh all the pluses and you weigh all the minuses, Stinger against Van Vader, seems like there might be a few more minuses over on the Stinger side. Because you got me by 200 pounds. Because you're stronger, because you're bigger. And because you say that you feel no pain. That you're barely even human. But let me tell you something. I know you're human, and I'm human too. And I'm going to figure out a way. And believe me, I can figure out a way, and I will figure out a way to make you understand what pain is all about and what fear is all about. The chair's not going to work. The Stinger Splash is not going to work. Change the tactics. That's what I'm going to do against you, Big Van Vader. I want you to know something. 5 minutes into the match, I'm going to be moving left when you're going to the right, and vice versa. 15 minutes into the match, I'm going to be in your face. 17, 18, 19, 20 minutes, I'm still going to be in your face, hopefully with your tongue hanging halfway out, because I know you're going to try and mow right over me in the first 3, 4, 5 minutes. It ain't going to be that game. I didn't become world champion by a stroke of luck. I keep saying that, but it's the truth, Van Vader. I'm going to figure out a way, believe me. You will figure out what pain is all about, and you're going to figure out, my friend, what fear is all about when you feel me. I'm the Stinger. Woo!
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest, it is set for one fall. Tag team action. Introducing first, from Warner Robins, Georgia, weighing 278 pounds, the All-American, Ron Simmons. His tag team partner from the North Woods, weighing 275 pounds, Big Josh.
They are the former United States Tag Team Champions. And what a team. Big Josh, who a year ago, Jesse, had never wrestled. He was a lumberjack, and now he's become quite a wrestler. And of course, we know all about Ron Simmons as we go back to the introduction of the champs.
Ladies and gentlemen, their opponents. They are the World Tag Team Champions, accompanied by the Chief Executive Officer of the Dangerous Alliance, Paul E. Dangerously. Introducing first, from Huntsville, Alabama, 233 pounds, Beautiful Bobby. His tag team partner, Minnesota, 248 pounds, the Enforcer, Arn Anderson.
That sign, Arn and Bobby can't win, I know it's got to be directed at their impending match with the Steiners' return battle for the World Tag Team title.
Well, I'll tell you what, Arn and Bobby, the champions, are facing a very unorthodox team. I mean, I can't imagine what Ron Simmons and Big Josh could possibly have in common. What do you think that they talk about on their free time, Shivani?
Well, maybe Ron talks about how he used to cut down football.
I mean, do you think Big Josh knows about rap music?
No.
I doubt it.
I'm sure he likes country and western.
He likes hillbilly music.
Josh is a very unorthodox wrestler. He's very strong. He always brings an axe handle with him. And immediately, he faces the double-teaming maneuvers of the Dangerous Alliance. As Bobby got a knee in that time, but Arn can't get him up. Oh, good move. And a cover. Bobby covered his partner's back that time, and Ron Simmons cuts him off. And quickly, we've got a four-way going here.
Absolutely. The referee better get some type of control, and Big Simmons catches Beautiful Bobby in the big squeeze of the bear hug right in the center of the ring.
But once again, you have to deal with the numbers. The Dangerous Alliance always had the outnumbered, always had him looking the other way. And Simmons takes down Bobby, and now takes down on Anderson. 3-point stance. Ron Simmons. Scoop and a slam. What a tremendous athlete. He may have a three. No, he only got a one. Wow, and Bobby has to go on the outside, and now the team champions have to rethink.
Very smart, though. You can tell Paulie Dangerously always thinking. There you see Paulie.
He's not Lawrence Taylor.
There you can hear the comments of Paulie outside the ring and Arn Anderson, the enforcer.
What does Paulie think pushing the camera out of the way is going to accomplish?
You know what makes them great champions? They're not only wrestlers, they're thinkers. Paulie has these two guys, Beautiful Bobby and Arn Anderson. They think, smart move. The match wasn't going their way. They bail out, they regroup, they come back again to fight.
Full arm drag and twist by Simmons, and here comes Big Josh. Look at this for a lumberjack. He's developed quite well in the sport. Double axe handle right on the arm of Bobby, and he goes to the eyes. Gets the shortcut every time.
Hey, I don't care how big or how strong you are, you have a vulnerable point always, and that's the eyes.
Bobby knows how to use every advantage. Get it, look at this. With the leg, sending Bobby down. He nailed him with a forearm that time, and now his log roll. Oh, all the weight right on the chest. Right on the sternum of Bobby, he's gonna hightail it out of there. Look at Arn slowing things down.
Absolutely. You always gotta change the pace if things aren't going your way. Arn Anderson, a veteran all the way. Always thinking, has that know-how in the ring. And look at Big Josh throwing them wild haymakers. What do you think he's thinking of? MC Hammer can't touch this?
Are you finished now?
Don't you dare interrupt me, Shivani. Go ahead.
Well, thank you. I'd like to say, if I could, many people feel that even though they are the World Tag Team Champions, and more than likely you're going to disagree, that the Steiners would be the favorites in the big return match.
No way. The Steiners were the favorites at Super Brawl, and they couldn't win it.
Josh with a left hand. Well, we could argue this point all the time, but it was a mere fact that inadvertently Rick Steiner belly-to-belly the referee, or maybe the Steiners would be the champions right now.
Inadvertently?
Inadvertently.
How do you inadvertently accost and attack a referee?
He was blinded, Jesse. You were there. You were there at ringside. Oh, no, my home.
And there again, the thinking wrestler, Arn Anderson, pulls his partner, Beautiful Bobby, out of the way. Simmons all the way out to the floor. And now the big man from Florida State's going to get punished. He's going to be screaming, Bobby Bowden, where are you? Come and save me, Coach Bowden.
No, he's not. Up on top. Double axe handle right on the back. Bobby now is going to make a cover.
You know, that was Ron Simmons' familiar position at football, right there. Flat on his back after getting knocked down.
Bobby now with a cheap shot again to the eyes. He's been full of cheap shots this week. He's up top. High risk maneuver. Simmons going to meet him, maybe. Yes! Power slam. And that's what made Simmons a great star at Florida State. Gutsy, never say die. And he's trying to make a tag right now. Bobby makes a tag. Both ends. Jazz going to take on both men.
And he's doing a hell of a job of it right now with lefts and rights in there.
Wait a minute. Bobby goes down. Arn's got the phone. What does he want to do? Make a phone call?
Yeah, he's probably calling his stockbroker.
Oh, for crying out loud, Jesse. You know what's coming on here. The only one that doesn't know is Big Josh and the referee. Everybody knows. People can see it here. Again, the Dangerous Alliance. What will they stoop to? Big Josh is ready for the Northern Exposure. He got it.
And Arn gets him.
Oh, for crying out loud. The phone on the head.
And he didn't dial the wrong number on that one, Shivani.
That's it.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winners of the match, the World Tag Team Champions, Arn Anderson and Beautiful Bobby.
Well, well. They stole another one.
Hey, nobody said they weren't thieves, but we did say they are the WCW World Heavyweight Tag Team Champions.
There's more.
Golf swings into a...
Earlier on in the hour, we announced the teams for War Games coming your way May 17th as part of the WrestleWar 92 pay-per-view exclusive. Now, Sting's team, consisting of Barry Windham, Dustin Rhodes, and Ricky Steamboat, have more than enough professional and emotional motivation to take advantage of the opportunity that having the entire Dangerous Alliance inside of a steel cage provides. But what about Nikita Koloff? So far, Koloff's actions have provided more questions than answers. As I said earlier, there's no question that Koloff brings experience to the team, but the Dangerous Alliance is not without war game experience. AA Arn Anderson is standing by. Let's get his comments now.
A little earlier, Nikita Koloff came out talking about experience in war games. Well, Nikita, I've been in every kind of match on this planet. A lot of people think I've been in this business years longer than I have. I've been beat up every which kind of way there is. And what I do after each and every one of those matches is I just go get me about a 12-pack of Novocaine, and I'm fine the next day because I'm all man. But after the first war games, I got to tell you, in Atlanta, Georgia, against what we had to contend with, the next morning, I didn't roll out of bed because there was no next morning. I went straight to the hospital. In this war games, it can be no different. Somebody's got to get hurt, possibly 10 somebodies. I know all about it. I hope your team does.
Well, certainly the bad blood that exists between these athletes is just cause for World Championship Wrestling to sign these two teams to such a dangerous match. But looking at the track record of the Dangerous Alliance, you can't help but wonder what kind of ace Paul E. Dangerously has up his sleeve. And we'll be hearing from the CEO of the Dangerous Alliance later on in the hour. But now, a big announcement from the WCW Championship Committee. Beginning May 2nd, Worldwide Wrestling will host the Nintendo Top 10 Challenge. Now, this single elimination tournament will be seen across the United States on Worldwide Wrestling, and it will name the number one contender to the heavyweight championship of the world. Now, this is a very unique opportunity for the athletes currently rated in the WCW top 10. Here's how the tournament will work. The current number one contender will face the number 10 contender. Number two will meet number nine, number three, number eight, and so on. Now, what makes the Nintendo Top 10 Challenge so exciting is that it will provide athletes currently rated towards the bottom of the top 10 with an opportunity to catapult themselves into a title shot. The WCW Championship Committee has frozen the top 10. Let's take a look.
And now here's a look at the WCW Top 10 rankings in singles competition. The number 10 ranked man, the TaylorMade Man, one half of the U.S. Tag Team Champs. In at number 9, Cactus Jack. Number 8, Barry Windham. The number 7 ranked contender, All-American Ron Simmons. And number 6, the Cruncher, Larry Zbyszko. In at number 5, the natural Dustin Rhodes. The World Television Champion Stunning Steve Austin is number 4. Number 3, the awesome Big Van Vader. Number 2, Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. And the number 1 ranked contender is the U.S. Heavyweight Champion, Ravishing Rick Rude. And that's a look at the WCW Top 10.
Well, as I said, wrestling fans, the athletes currently rated towards the bottom of the Top 10 will see this as an opportunity of a lifetime. Stay with us. Tony Schiavone and Jesse the Body Ventura will be back with more action on Worldwide Wrestling right after this very brief timeout.
The WCW Special Forces, ladies and gentlemen, one half of the Patriots, Chick the Firebreaker.
One half of the Patriots, tremendously popular athlete. He is also one half of the former U.S. Tag Team Champions and quite an athlete. As we wait the opponent, who I'm sure is going to play for us.
And ladies and gentlemen, his opponent. He is from Asbury Park, New Jersey. He weighs 231 pounds, J.T. Southern.
Hold your ears, Jess. He's going to burst some eardrums here.
I like it.
You would like that.
Got a little Jimmy Page going for him. You know who Jimmy Page is?
Yeah, I know who Jimmy Page is.
Who is he?
Wasn't he a classical guitarist at one time?
Yeah, classical with Led Zeppelin, that's who.
All right. The only man in WCW that plays his own entrance music. J.T. Southern, who had some very... Is he going to play or what here? You know, he called Van Hammer. He said he doesn't play his own guitar. He doesn't sing his own music. That he was a phony. That's what he claims.
He's kind of, Van Hammer's kind of like Milli Vanilli, right?
Yeah, that's exactly what he said.
Win the Grammy, but you don't do it yourself. Some guy over in Germany does it all.
Okay, we also understand J.T. Southern has been saying some derogatory things about the Freebirds, about Johnny B. Badd. He made also the same claim that you did, that Johnny B. Badd says that Little Richard is his hero, but he's never seen him behind the piano. Claims he's the only original in WCW, J.T. Southern, going up against Chip the Firebreaker, and this very, very accomplished guitarist, who we understand is a great wrestler as well. We saw him a week ago, and he showed us something. Pushes Chip out of the way. Kind of cocky, too.
Well, you can tell, I can tell right now, that this Chip the Firebreaker, you know what his major problem is, Schiavone?
Oh, what's that?
He's got a short man complex. You can tell it right away. All these short guys who wish that they were tall.
Double axe handle. And he's got, wait a minute, he's going to send Southern.
Now, what did the guy do to deserve that? This guy Chip's a little rule breaker, ain't he?
Well, I think he's like a little fire plug, if I can say that. Use that term. Look at him. He's got a head of steam on him now, sending J.T. Southern to the corner, going after Southern.
Kicking and punching and fighting on the floor, running the rock and roll guitar player into the fence outside the ring.
He is not going to be intimidated and taunted by J.T. Southern, and Chip the Firebreaker is going after him. Southern needs to rethink his strategy here. He's been overwhelmed early on. Oh, he moved. But Chip held on. Great agility. Up top. He better turn around.
Oh, caught him at the clothesline off the top. That could be the end.
Southern escape nicely done by JT Southern, the rock and roller. And Chip is not finished yet. I don't know why you said he had a short man's complex.
Whoa. You can tell.
You can just look at somebody and tell?
You can tell.
Clothesline again. Chip. Going after him one more time. Southern came in playing his rock and roll. And right now he's still really, he moved. And he rolls him up. He's using the rope.
He got him. Guitar, he can wrestle and he can hide things from a referee and sneak out a victory.
And he can cheat, for crying out loud.
It's only cheating, Shabani, if you get caught. Always remember that. Here you see Chip the Firebreaker diving in, hits his chin right on the buckle. Southern rolls him up into a cradle, feet up on the top rope for a little extra leverage. Referee digging in deep, counts the three count. Smart victory.
Okay, Jesse Ventura, an illegal, but a win nonetheless for JT Southern. You know, fans, it was a week ago right here on WCW Worldwide Wrestling. We saw one of the worst attacks I've ever seen in WCW, an attack by Ravishing Rick Rude. First of all, with the chair, and then with the help of the Dangerous Alliance, taking the face of Ricky the Dragon Steamboat into the concrete. Steamboat had to be helped out. As we said, we understand he received a very severe face injury, a broken nose. And we are here this week with the first interview with the man who had that attack on his face just a week ago. So please, everybody in Topeka, welcome back with me, the one and only Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. Okay, Ricky, it was a horrible attack. You've had a chance to think about it, I know. First of all, the severity of your injury, and what's going through your mind right now?
Well, Mr. Savani, let me tell you about pain. Let me tell you about dislocated shoulders, fractured ribs, cracked vertebrae and base of spines. Let me tell you about the pain over the course of the years of my wrestling career. Well, let me tell you about the biggest pain that I have ever had to suffer in my life. And that is the night that I had to go home. The night that I had to face my 4.5-year-old son and have him look at me and look at me and say, Daddy, Daddy, what happened to your face? Who did this to you? With all the violence and the drugs that is going on in our world today, what do you tell a little 4.5-year-old boy? What do you tell that son of mine? Do I tell him about the violence? Let me tell you something, Rick Rude, as you look into this face that has been shattered, a broken nose, a shattered cheekbones. Let me tell you about the real pain that I have been suffering and the pain that's going to be inflicted upon you. I'm going to get you, my man, where it hurts you worst. I'm going to capture the gold around that waist. And to do so, to inflict bodily harm upon that ravishing body of yours, in the course of it, it will happen, my friend. It will happen. You will suffer the Almighty. You will retreat from that gold around your waist. Listen to these people. Listen to them talk. They tell you. Ravishing Rick, this is not the Dragon's final chapter. I will not kneel down to you and the Dangerous Alliance. I will make a comeback, and in do so, I will hurt you while it hurts you the most, and that is, I will capture the United States Heavyweight Championship belt. Let it be written, let it be said, these people know.
Ricky the Dragon Steamboat, and we'll be back on the Worldwide right after this. Jesse,
Jesse, back with you here on Worldwide. A very emotional talk that time from the Dragon.
Well, it was emotional, but I couldn't figure it out. Was he doing a Charles Barkley impersonation?
No, he wasn't doing a Charles Barkley, but I tell you what, he is hot after ravishing Rick Rude in the U.S. title, no question.
He can be as hot as he wants after ravishing Rick Rude in the U.S. title, but let me tell you something, Dragon. I think your days are numbered, I think you're over the hill, and I don't think you can come back ever and take the gold from ravishing Rick Rude. I mean, the guy's up here crying and whining. This is a rough business, Shivani. You get hurt. That's the bottom line.
Speaking about getting hurt, Sting knows the pain from Big Van Vader. Big Van Vader coming up next against Marcus Alexander Bagwell.
Well, little Bagwell will be bagged, I think, when Big Van Vader's done with him.
450 pounds, Big Van Vader and Marcus Alexander Bagwell. When WCW Worldwide with Tony and Jesse the Body continue after this.
Following contest, it is set for one fall. Introducing first, from Marietta, Georgia, weighing 234 pounds, Marcus Alexander Bagwell.
Tremendous ovation for this youngster out of Marietta, Georgia. Right out of high school, he has made a name for himself in WCW. What?
You know, I thought this kid had some smarts, but he's obviously stupid.
Take a look what's coming up the aisle.
And that's why.
His opponent from the Rocky Mountains, weighing 445 pounds, Big Van Vader.
Of all the attacks which Sting has suffered, in being world champion, of course, back when he was U.S. heavyweight champion, the most serious one is from this guy right here.
You know, like I said, I thought Bagwell had a future. You know, he wrestles pretty well for a young rookie, and he does a lot of things well, but he's obviously a stupid fool. I mean, for a rookie to step in the ring with Big Van Vader, who's advising this kid, Shivani?
Well, I don't know, but couldn't you call this courage? Willingness instead of stupidity?
No, there's a difference between courage and stupidity.
Oh, Van Vader doesn't even budge. When someone hits him, someone tries to run into him, he doesn't even move. He's incredible. Look at this. Oh, he's too much.
You know, this kid's pretty. He's got that pretty face. All the girls swoon over him. He's going to look worse than Vader when this is over. Wasn't Sting training this kid?
Yes, at one time he was training.
You're telling me then the champion sent this lamb into the wolves?
No, Jesse, you can't say it was like that at all.
How do you know?
Well, but I'm sure Bagwell makes his own decisions. Oh, my goodness.
Well, if he makes his own decisions, he's in dire need of a manager to make the decisions for him.
Here's your winner, Big Van Vader.
The kid is hurt. He's not moving.
Now you can bet he's hurt. Now, he's going to hurt more now.
Wait a second. Ahead of steam. He's not. Oh, no.
Woof.
Look at the man who says he feels no pain. He fears no man. Oh, my goodness. I can't believe we need to get some officials or something to clear him out of the ring. The referee's going to get out of his way.
He's going up the ropes on him?
No.
Bye-bye, rookie. No. So long, rookie.
Vader! He could crush a rib cage like that.
I'll tell you what, Sting should be ashamed of himself for sending this kid into the ring to do his job for him.
Here he comes. Sting's gonna pull him out. Sting's gonna pull this kid out.
Well, it's about time he showed up. A little bit after the fact, ain't it, Shivani?
Finally, Sting back in his dressing room area, helping this youngster. Officials out for World Championship Wrestling referees. Bagwell's in serious trouble here.
Sting!
He's
calling for the champ.
No fear, no pain. You are dead. Come on, Steve. Come on.
I think if Sting is smart, he'll go back to the dressing room with Bagwell.
Don't confuse courage with stupidity. This is courage. He's going in and the big guy's attacking him.
I think this is stupidity too. I mean, first he had to come in the ropes. He catches an elbow. Now he's at the mercy of Big Vader.
Yes! Sting! Going after Vader! He may knock him off his feet! He did! What do you think about this?
He caught him with the drop kick!
And Vader's up! If he wants Sting, he knows where to find him in the ring! There's gonna be another day, and when these two collide for the title, I want to see it!
Well, Tony, I think it's obvious that for the time being at least, Sting's only concern is Van Vader. And at nearly 450 pounds, that is definitely one big concern. But with War Games coming May 17th and all the questions surrounding Nikita Koloff, Sting and his team must be wondering what this pay-per-view exclusive holds for their future. If Koloff is going to align himself with Sting's team, it'll be a devastating blow for the Dangerous Alliance. But what if Koloff is just another Paul E. Dangerously pawn? Let's hear from the CEO.
You see, Sting, I know what's going through your mind. Is Nikita on my side, or is he on theirs? Is he an ally, or is he part of the Dangerous Alliance? He could be to your benefit, Sting, but he could also be to ours. And while you're thinking, while you're wondering, while the mystery perplexes you, we're preparing for the most brutal event in the history of World Championship Wrestling. You're wondering while we're preparing for the War Games.
Well, it sounds to me like Dangerously is about to shed another layer of skin. He's going to crawl out from underneath a rock and continue his assault on WCW by destroying its stars. Certainly War Games will provide Sting and his team with an opportunity to put an end to the Dangerous Alliance if, and only if, Nikita Koloff can be trusted. I'm Eric Bischoff for the WCW Magazine. Tony Schiavone and Jesse the Body Ventura will be back right after this very short time.
The fans here are still chanting, "We want Sting," and I know Big Van Vader wants Sting as well.
That's right, and somewhere down the line, someplace, Big Van Vader's gonna get his hands on Sting, and Sting may rue the day that he ever became the champion of the world to have guys like Vader breathing down his neck.
We hope next week to get a report on the injury to Marcus Alexander Bagwell. He really took a beating at 450-pound Big Van Vader. Next week, the tailor-made man goes one-on-one against the Z-Man right here on Worldwide.
And that's going to be a great, great matchup. But again, I got to say it, Schiavone. How could Sting send that little rookie in there to take that kind of beating for him?
Once again, I got to disagree with him. He didn't send Bagwell in there. Bagwell came on his own accord. He's a courageous young man. There's no question about that.
No, he's a stupid young man, Schiavone.
For Jesse the Body Ventura, I'm Tony Schiavone. See you next week on WCW Worldwide.
Yeah.